Morning students, how are you today? Hope you're all fine. And what about your parents? Think all of you are staying at home and keeping yourself safe. Are you ready for today's class? Yes, you're ready. Very good. Welcome back to today's class. Do anyone remember what we studied yesterday? Yes. The selfish giant part 1. We studied selfish giant part 1. Can anyone tell me the story so far we studied in yesterday's class? Anyone? Yes. The selfish giant had a beautiful lovely garden, and in his garden there used to be many flowers and fruit. Birds used to come and sit on tree tops and sing delightfully, sing sweet songs. He went to visit his friend. He stayed with his friend for 7 years. And during his absence, children used to enter his garden. They look at the beautiful flowers and enjoy. They listen to the songs of the birds and enjoy. And they used to play many games in his garden after their school hours. But after 7 years, the giant came back and he found the children playing in his garden. He was very selfish and he did not like the children playing in his garden. That is why he shouted at the children, "This is my garden. My own garden is my own garden. No one can enter my garden." Hearing his harsh voice, the children were afraid and they ran away from there. After that, what did the selfish giant do? Yes, he built a high wall all around his garden so that no one can enter inside. Not only that, he put up a notice. Can anyone tell me what is the notice written? Yes. "Trespassers will be prosecuted," which means if any people enter without his permission, they will be punished. That's the meaning of the notice. Trespassers will be prosecuted. Then he used to stay in his castle. Time passed by. All over the country, the spring season came. Happy season, delightful season, where the trees give flowers and fruit, birds come and sing. Very sunny days, bright days. But in the giant's garden, it was still winter, no spring. Flowers were not there, birds did not come, trees did not give flowers and fruit. It was all snowy, north wind was there, frost was there. Everything, it was very cold in his garden. Whereas the remaining part of the country, it was spring season, happy season. Birds were singing songs. There were blossoms all over the country, fruit all over the country, except in his garden. All this we studied in yesterday's lesson. Clear? Now, we shall continue today part 2, second part of the story, The Selfish Giant. Who is the author of this story, author of this lesson? Oscar Wilde. What is his name? Oscar Wilde. So it is a play. It is a play which can be acted on the stage. Clear? Very interesting to read. Shall we continue today's lesson? You ready? If you have textbooks, open your textbooks, take The Selfish Giant part 2. "One morning I was lying awake in bed when I heard some lovely music. It sounded so sweet that I thought it must be the king's musicians passing by. One morning, as the giant was lying awake in his bed, maybe the early morning hours, he heard a lovely music, beautiful music. Hearing that music, the giant thought that the king's musicians are passing by and playing that lovely music. but it was really only a little linnet bird singing outside my window. Then he understood that it was not any music played by any musician, but the lovely music was sung by a small bird, a tiny bird known as linnet bird. Linnet, L-I-N-N-E-T. Linnet bird. Okay? Linnet bird is a small brown bird which sings very sweet songs, very beautiful music. It was so long since I heard a bird sing in my garden that it seemed to me to be the most beautiful music in the world. After several years, he heard that such a lovely music, and it was coming from a corner of his garden. In his garden, on a tree, a linnet bird was sitting and singing. Generally, birds come in during spring season and sing. He thought it was the most beautiful music in the world. So the gent says, "The hail has stopped dancing over my head. The north wind has ceased its roaring. A delicious smell is coming from the window. I believe the spring has come at last." The selfish giant had been waiting for the arrival of the spring season in his garden. Now, hearing the beautiful music of a linnet bird, he thought, "At last, the spring season has arrived in his garden." When the spring comes, something goes out. What is that? The north wind, the hail, the frost, the snow, everything has run away and the spring has arrived. It was no more cold in his beautiful garden. The giant jumps out of bed and looks out. He was so happy at the arrival of the spring season, and he looked out through the window. Through a little hole in the wall, the children have crept in and are sitting on the branches of the tree. When he looked out, what did he notice in his garden? Through a small hole in the wall, he built a wall, high wall, all around the garden. There was a small hole. The children, small children, crept into the garden through this hole. And they started playing in his garden. They started climbing the trees, sitting on the branches of the tree. Okay? So, old giant says, "In every tree I could see a little child. The trees were so glad to have the children back again, and they had covered themselves with blossoms. And every tree, the giant found a child sitting. When the children arrived sitting on the trees, the trees were so happy. The trees were so happy. And they covered themselves with blossoms. The trees covered themselves with flowers. Clear? And were waving their arms gently above the children's heads." Waving their arms. What are arms of trees? Yes? Their branches. The trees started waving their branches over the children, above the children, above their heads. The birds were flying above and twittering with delight. Not only children, there were birds, many other birds flying in his garden and twittering. What is meaning of twitter? T-W-I-T-T-E-R. The sound made by birds. It is the sound made by birds. The sound made by birds. The birds were singing in his garden. That's the meaning. Twittering delight, and flowers were looking up the green grass and laughing. See, beautiful writing. The flowers were looking up through the grass, and what were they doing again? The flowers were laughing. The flowers were laughing. Can the flowers really laugh? No? No, they cannot laugh. But the poet, the writer, can make the flowers to laugh through his writing. This type of writing is called as the expective personification. Personification meaning making non-living objects to speak, to behave like human beings. The flowers were laughing. It was a lovely scene, only in one corner it was still winter. So all over this garden, it was a lovely scene. How was it? The children were playing happily. The trees were waving their branches, their arms. The birds were singing. The flowers were looking up and laughing. All delightful scene, pleasant scene in his garden. But in one corner, it was still winter. In a far corner of his garden, it was still winter season. In that corner, there were no birds, no flowers. The cold wind was there, frost was there, snow was there. It was winter. Only in one particular corner of his garden. Why? It was the farthest corner of the garden, and in it was standing a little boy. In that farthest corner, where it was still winter, a small child, small boy was standing. And what was he doing there? He was so small that he could not reach up to the branches of the tree. And he was wandering all round him, crying bitterly. The small boy could not climb the tree. So he was crying. He was wandering all around the garden, wandering, you see, walking about in the garden, trying to climb a tree. Because he was very small, he could not climb the trees. The poor tree was still quite covered with frost and snow, and the north wind was blowing and roaring above it. Above that tree, the north wind was blowing. The tree was covered with snow. It was still winter as we studied. It was still winter there in a particular corner. Climb up, little boy, said the tree, and it bent its branches down as low as it could. The tree said, climb up, little boy. And the tree bent the branches very low, almost touching the ground. Here also, the tree spoke. Can the tree really speak? So what type of expression is it? It is personification. Personification. Making non-living objects to speak, to behave like human beings. Personification. Person. Okay. So the tree said, climb up, little boy. And it bent its branches low as it could, very close to the ground. But the little boy was too tiny. It was then that my heart melted. The little boy was too tiny, very small, maybe 3 or 4 years child. So he could not climb the tree. Though the tree tried to help the boy to climb on it, still the boy could not climb. The tree also made him very sad, very sad. And who was watching all this scene? The giant. The giant was watching what the boy was doing, what the tree was doing. Looking at that scene, my heart melted. James said, my heart melted. Melt means to become soft. What is the meaning of the word melt? M-E-L-T, melt. Melt meaning to become soft. Here, he felt sympathy for the boy, kindness, pity for the little boy who was crying because he could not climb the tree. So the giant said, how selfish I have been. The giant realized his mistake. All those days and months he had been very selfish. He did not allow anyone to enter his garden. Now he has realized this mistake and said, how selfish I have been. Now I know why the spring would not come here. He understood and said, now I know why the spring didn't come to my garden. Can anyone tell me why the spring season has not come into his garden? Can anyone tell? Yes, because he was selfish, he did not allow anyone to enter his garden. That is the reason the spring did not come into his garden. Now only the giant understood his mistake. I will put that little boy on the top of the tree, and then I will knock down the wall, and my garden shall be the children's playground forever and ever. So the giant decided to knock down the wall, to destroy the wall and allow the children to enter his garden freely and play in his garden. He liked to see the little children playing in his garden. He enjoyed the spring season in his garden. So the giant realized this mistake. He broke down the wall that he built around his garden, and he welcomed the children to come in his garden and play happily. Okay children, we'll stop here and we'll continue the next part of the lesson in our next class. Have a good day.